Hi, my name is David McDermott. I own McDermott Glass Studio in Sandwich, Massachusetts, on Cape Cod. And we all have different techniques of how we make glass. And this is a little different way. It's a Scottish method. And it's a little quicker, a little hotter. And I'm going to show you just different things that we've been doing in the class. And we'll see how it goes from there. The very first thing I learned how to make was a swan. It's kind of an Italian horse, in a way. It teaches you everything you need to know about glass, how to work it, different steps, what heat should I be at, how fast I should work. So what we're doing is we're just bringing the glass out, flattening a little bit. And it's pinch, pinch, beak, tail, head. Give it a little slight cut in. And now I'm just waiting for the right temperature. You can either tell by color or feel. Cut it in. Straighten it out a little bit. Knock it off. Like I said, it's a quick way to learn steps, heat, timing. It'll show you pretty much everything you need to know about glass. And the next thing we learned in our class was how to make a tumbler, but make it a little bit quicker. You want weight at the bottom so you make it a little bit longer. Thumb it. Use the heat, let gravity take it. Get a neck on it. Blow a little bit. Let gravity take it, go a little bit longer. Little cut in. Rub the side a little bit. Flash and then just the bottom. And just so it's not plain, we'll do a little decoration on it. I don't know what you guys call it. We call it a schling. Melt it in a little bit. Now I'm just heating up the very end. We shear everything. Always want to kind of push down a little bit. I'm even blind with these. Paper jack. And just open it up. It's a quick glass that you can sell. Another thing we're learning here are handles, different types of handles. So we're just going to make a mug. We'll put three or four different handles on it. Again, everybody has different techniques. The way you do it might be different. It's the result that matters. Everything we do kind of starts out with that light bulb shape. If you want it thicker on the bottom, you make it longer. And let gravity do it. The more you work the glass, the more it looks like you worked it. So if you can trick the glass into doing what you want, you're better off. Thank you. let it run. Same thing, let it run again. Let it get its own length. Not quite as long as I want, so I reheat it. When I come out, I'm just going to give it a little swing just to get it a little bit longer. Give it a little puff. Rub the sides. Push the bottom up. Again, the same thing. It's done from the shoulder down, so you really don't have to worry about that. So now I'm just going to shear it. Sharing, you kind of want to just keep cutting small cuts until you hear it hit the floor. That way you know you've got it nice and straight. The first handle we're going to do, we call it a backstock handle where I learned. It's attached to the top, flipped over, and attached to the bottom. So Isabel is gathering out the handle. When you're working with somebody, putting on the handle is the easy part. Everything depends upon the person that's given it to you. The right temperature, the right shape. So you grab it, you touch, pull away a little bit, flatten it, stand up, pull away a little bit, and snip it off. Then you grab your pincers, grab at the very bottom, pull, flip over, touch, and twist. You could do a little decoration if you want. So that's called a backstuck. Now we're going to do what we call a regular handle, which is attached at the bottom and flipped over on the top. This one is straight up and down, push, pull up, then flip up and over and let it fall in between your pincers, touch and push out, spin, go back in, flatten, spin, and then get your graphite rod in there. I don't know what anybody else would call it, we just call it regular. Next one we're going to do is a hollow handle. Basically, it's going to look just like the regular, but it's going to be hollow. Just keep reheating just so it doesn't explode and I look like a total idiot. So again, Isabel is doing pretty much all the work. Take your time, a little bit longer. Straight flat. Again, it's up, flip over, let it hit your pincers, touch, push, spin. Go back in, flatten, spin. Push up. Now we'll do somebody called it a Roman handle. Will you squeeze it? And all Isabel's going to do is just pinch it with her pincers. Makes it a little flatter, plus it's got a little decoration to it. Down, pull up, snip. Flip up, flips over, touch, push out, spin. Then flat, spin again. So those are some quick handles. 40 minutes left, huh? So next, we apply bits a little bit differently than most, and this is another thing that we're learning in class. So I'll do 3 or 4 bits on one piece just to show you how we do it, how it's supposed to look, hopefully. Yeah. This one will make like a bowl shape. I didn't let it run, pallet it to make it longer because I want a little more weight on the sides and a little less on the bottom. Basically, it's the same moves. Just let it hang, run away. Pretty much everything we do has a neck on it, like a light bulb shape. I'm just taking the bowl of the tools and cooling down the neck. The glass is still so hot, I just want to make it stable. So usually you use gravity to make a piece longer. I want to squat this bowl back. So if you want to make it squat, you still use gravity. And you're just going to hold it up in the air. Let it squat back. Give it a little puff. So like I said, we apply bits a little bit differently. This is called casting on. Basically, what you do is just make a quick cut in, flip up, and let it trail off. Flatten the bottom. It's kind of quick, so I'll do 2 or 3 of these just to show you. Original heat can't be beat. Slight cut, up in the air. Look at your center. turn, have that leading edge over, and let it fall off. Again, just flatten. Yeah, we'll do one more. It's the reason I'm putting two or three on, just so that you can see how fast, how hot, where to hit. Now, if it doesn't break, good. I'm going to cool the bottom. All glass works a little differently. This isn't the type of glass that I usually use. Ooh, boy. Glass is still hot, a little loose. My particular glass sets up a little bit faster, so I may have to fool around with this a little bit. Again, I'm just heating up the top. Want to shear it. Exactly. Half an hour. Sweet. I'm not very good at this, by the way. Always make sure your base is straight before you shear. I try to use centrifugal force. We do a thing called heat, speed, and angle. If you heat it up to a certain temperature and you turn it at a certain speed and hold it at a certain angle, you can trick the glass to doing into what you want it to do. So if I hold it level and turn it, it's going to get wider. If I hold it down, it's going to get shorter and the hole's going to open up at the top. now. I'm just going to flare out the top. And if you don't keep your bottom straight, that's what happens. So that just shows you how to cast on a bit, how to use the heat, speed, angle. Next we're gonna do a wine glass. It's gonna show you how to use, how to make a leg, how to put a foot on. We use a foot board. So, thanks. A little water never hurt. A little bit more for the... And it's pretty much the same thing, let it run. You want the light bulb shape. So Isabel's going to bring me over a bit. We're going to turn it into, we call it a calf leg. It's going to look like the calf on the back of your leg. tapping it to make the button nice and flat. Brush your tools. This is the footboard. And I'm just heating up the top. I'm getting quieter and quieter. That's a wine glass. Shows you how to do a leg and a foot. Next we're going to do like a pitcher or a ewer. And it has, just shows you how to run something away. Thank you. Now, I'm doing everything with single gathers. Whether you're doing double gathers, single gathers, triple gathers, it's all the same. Just may take a little bit longer with the more heat you have. This one, I'm going to want to wait a little bit more weight on the bottom. So I am going to make it longer. Now I want to make a cut about 3/4 inch in and then slope out and just stretch just a little bit. Give it a cut in at the top and then go right back in. Give the neck a chance to cool down a little bit before you start to blow. I want to make it a little bit longer on the bottom. So I'm just going to heat the bottom towards the middle. And just give it a little swing. And then just take your pad, you can shape it, you can do whatever you design or whatever you want to do. And now Isabel's going to get me a foot. Now you can just stroke the foot out to make it smooth, or you can put a little decoration in there. Oh, Jesus. You definitely want to keep the neck warm. Especially when you go to crack it off. Hopefully this makes it. Where is she? So you want the lip, this is going to be a picture, so you want the lip a little bit higher. So we're going to do a little bit different shearing on it. Basically cut straight and down and up and then over. Smaller graphite, just for the lip. Not, no big deal. We're going to put a back stock on this handle. There's plenty there, so take your time. Touch, pull away. And re-grab, pull up, over, touch and twist. So that kind of shows you how to run something away a little bit longer and still have enough meat on the bottom to make a different shape. Will it never end? Really quick shape. People seem to like it. You can sell them quick, make money, pay your gas bill, pay your rental fee, then you got plenty of time to do your art. glass piece. Have we? Maybe I'll put a ball leg and a foot. Again, I want it longer. I want meat on the bottom. Cooling off the neck. So I'm going to put a little leg and a foot on it, just to show you the casting on. Small. Not crazy. Second. these techniques, you don't have to make these simple, quick shapes with them. You can incorporate them into complex shapes, designs. All it's going to do is just speed up your glass making a little bit. Bring it down and then bring it up. If you find that it collapses, just put your tools on the inside, slide out. Quick, simple, classic shapes. 12 o'clock.